were the three arms which sort of tried to guide the whole process towards reconciliation. I was a perpetrator, and I voluntarily came and I said, I killed 50 people. And this is how I killed them, and this is where they were. I must tell the whole truth. But there was another obligation. The obligation was on me to also prove that this was politically motivated. That's where the process went from. On the side of the people, of the victims, were asking very simple human questions. Who killed my child? Where are my child's remains? That was all. I was continuously surprised. By, on the one hand, the deep generosity of the people who were actual victims. Once they identified and they said, this is the man who killed your child. And the person asked, how did you kill him? First plus brutal, whichever way you can get it. Where are the remains? And they went to point out. So there was a period in our country where we're digging bones as if we were manufacturing them. We were committed to manufacturing throughout the length and breadth of the country. And the people eventually, when they, that was said, say, I'm prepared to deal with it. Majority of people were prepared to forgive. That, now that I know where the remains are, I need a stage to assist me to bury them, to give this person, this my child, a proper burial. Went on for 4 years. Over and over and over. It was a very important process because not a single South African today can say, I did not know. We all knew. Very important statement. Nobody, because up until then, there were people as well. We did not know that this was happening. But now we saw the faces of the perpetrators, we saw the faces of the victims, we saw the bones, we went into a really great detail of how these people died. It's part and parcel of our national consciousness now. And this is where the issue of choice comes in. Now that we have this consciousness, what is our choice? We cannot say anything.